first time in 8 years for a unification fight, and this guy was trying and he was in it till the end. The judges' scores were ridiculous. Sure, we might have lost the fight, but Joe never stopped trying all the way through it, and we were just beaten by a better, bigger man today. Joe's the youngest champion, and he will be back.
All right. Yeah.
We should all be very proud of this guy. Okay, right, so get that gloomy look off your face, and we're going to go party.
Previous fights, I trained hard, but I didn't really tick all the boxes. I knew what I had to do, but I didn't do everything right. When I found out that I was fighting in front of 80,000 people and fighting Anthony Joshua, something switched in my head and just changed everything. That made me lift my level to a level that I've never been to before. You know, there's a few times in the past where on a Friday night, you know, I don't really want to sleep early, so I get up to, you know, mischief, or I get up to no good. We won't go into detail. So I haven't had my rest, and then we go to the hills. Now, the hills and stairs are hard. Like, this is like next level stuff. My eyes are tired, and I'm sort of sore, and I'm restless. But then when I turn around to walk down, and Kev's looking at me, I'm all happy and chirpy. You know, this is the mistakes that I've made in the past. You can't make these mistakes at this level. You have to be a different beast altogether.
He has been very disciplined this camp. He realizes how big this is, and he takes it very, very seriously. He respects the position he's in and the opportunity that he's been given in this fight.
My dad's a good judge of my body when he sees me, you know. And every time I see my dad, before a fight, I take my shirt off and say, "Dad, how do I look?" This time, I take my shirt off and Dad goes, "Son, I've never seen you as good as you look now."
Joe looks really good now. Very lean and solid and fit. He's ready to rumble.
When I'm a little kid, you know, you want to make your parents proud and impress them. But like today he saw me training hard and he's like, "Hey son, I know you're tired, but man, you look good." I said, "Yeah, I'm not tired. You know, I'm fit, strong and healthy." "Dad, that's what good eating does. I'll show you."
This
is what the floor says?
This is Joe's floor.
Hey! Good to see you, bro.
Good to see you,
son. Long flight? Long? The whole camp, I was thinking, you know, can't wait to catch up with John. Because when I leave New Zealand, he goes and trains in Christchurch. I come, obviously, I go to Vegas and train, but as soon as I leave, I miss him straight away. And so we're always on the phone. Even though I text him and he doesn't text me back. I don't know if he's busy or not, but I'm always texting, calling, and he always answers my call. And then the whole camp, I'm like, can't wait to catch up with him. Can't wait to catch up with him.
No matter how many times I go through it, no matter how many times I go with Joe and travel with him to all of his fights, never gets old. It's always exciting, it's always something new. You know, feed off Joe's ambition. And he's always ambitious about fighting and his new opponents and new obstacles. So yeah, no, it's real cool.
He's fought on like 3 or 4 of my undercards, and he was meant to be fighting on this card too. So I called my dad at home, and then we're just chatting. Had a good chat, was having a nice, joyful chat. And I have a few laughs here and there, and then just out of nowhere, "Oh yeah, your brother's not fighting. Why is that?" "Oh, something wrong with his brain." I said, "What do you mean that? Like, Like, you know, you just said it casually.
And this was my first international fight. So in international rules, I had to get a full body scan to make sure I was eligible to fight. After the scan, they contacted my coach, Brian Barry, and they told him, and he called me up, and he said, look, John, it's really important, you just come home, which is unusual. So I thought, oh, damn it, what have I done? It's like, oh, I'm sure I'll hang up my washing. And then I went and I sat down, and he said, look, just got to let you know, you absolutely can't fight. Why? He said, there's something in your brain. You have an aneurysm.
I said, oh, man. So I called John, or I called Brian, and then I found out that he had an MRI scan. And an MRI scan showed that he had a little aneurysm in his brain, which is like a little blood clot, sort of.
We looked it up and found out that it was life-threatening if the little bubble popped, because then you'll bleed out in the brain, and then you cause a flooding of blood in the brain and could potentially die.
I'm gutted that he's missing out on a fight, but I'm so happy that he's not fighting. And we're gonna fix this, you know. So I think it's important that every fighter, maybe every year, should get a checkup. You know, you don't wanna be risking your life going into the ring when there's something wrong. Otherwise, you know, you can always miss out on a fight, but you can never get your life back.
Just getting ready for a press conference, I think we're just gonna talk about the fight coming up, but also the elbows, now that it's revealed. How it was restricting the punching and the benefits of the surgery. Now, it's a good news story because it's now I'm fighting 100%. Oh, you sort of, you get used to it, but the media stuff, that makes me nervous, you know? Yeah, you try and be yourself, but then you don't want to say anything wrong. You never know if you say something wrong or not, so you sort of get nervous and a bit stuck. Honestly, if I get up there and talk, and I take my jacket off, you'll see sweat patches, because I'm like...
Joseph, are you nervous? This is the number one question you get asked. Are you nervous?
Do I look nervous?
No, you don't.
I'm ready. Now, there's no problems with us, there's no complaints. I'm here to win and I'm here to take those belts. So you're going to get the full Joseph Parker now. And we're seeing every day double jab, triple jab, sometimes 10 jabs. So there's going to be a lot of jabs, and hopefully they land at the right place. You know, the nose, the hair, the chin.
Joe, when Anthony was asked if he liked you, he said no, and that he thinks you're a weird character.
It's very interesting that he said that, because it's very, you know, it's, he's sort of stepped out of his comfort zone and said something interesting. He's been boring lately. You know, he's trying to be leaner, trying to be faster, better movement. So I don't know if he's trying to be him or me. We're here to make our mark, and we're here to take this belt back to New Zealand and Samoa.
There's a couple of good names, Tako and Klitschko. Joseph's got a more well-rounded resume.
You know, I don't think he needs to worry about Joseph Parker's elbows. He needs to worry about Joseph Parker's hands smacking against his face.
Straight this way, Joseph.
I thought it was good. I thought it flowed well. I felt a bit greedy talking too much, but maybe I needed to.
I think you're coming of age in the media.
That's what everyone was saying.
You were cool, calm, collected, and there was genuine warmth, humour and wit, and you warmed up throughout, and I think you captured them. And afterwards, I had a few British journalists whisper to me that they're actually starting to like you, and one or two said they want you to knock Joshua out.
Oh, that's good. That's good feedback. We've changed a few minds.
We have.
It's calm before the storm. You aren't going to hear any smack talk from me. My job is done. This is about Joseph Parker and Anthony Joshua.
David's a little different, but he does what a promoter does. You know, he promotes the fight, he does his job, and he had a lot to do with getting this fight sorted.
Eddie was probably disappointed that I didn't perform for him at the press conference. Sorry, Eddie. If you want to make a scene, do it yourself.
I feel exhausted, battered. Since October, I've been scrapping. I feel like I've gone 15 rounds to one, build it in the media, and it feels uncomfortable being that provocative in the media. I'm actually quite shy.
We're not saying he has a glass jaw, but we're going to find out on March 31.
And don't take this as disrespect for Anthony Joshua. Who's got a better chin? Joseph Parker.
Never wear that turtleneck again. Never. It's disgusting.
Yeah, you've done it,
disgusting.
Dave, you've done it. High five.
Yeah, even promotion, you have to try and be courageous. I mean, you should see the hate mail that I get. Each morning I want to laugh. If I want to laugh, I open up Twitter and British fans, they'll just relentlessly ridicule me and say, have a good laugh. Like, one of my favourites is Higgins. You really are a sad, desperate C-word. Before the Fury fight, someone said, when you get to Manchester, we're going to slit your fucking throat. Imagine receiving that. And I was a little bit worried, so I rang Peter Fury and said, mate, and he kindly said he's going to put the word out that I'm not to be touched.
So, if you can wait around here, it's just quite nice.
The boxing game can get quite confusing and quite challenging in other areas, you know, like the legal side of things and contracts and all that.
To the letter, I've worked in all the little things. You've got to put contract everything. The rope, the ring can't be bigger than 20 foot outside the rope. The clauses on referees and judges. We want 12 people allowed in the dressing room, 4 seconds working the corner, 5 towels. We want a flat screen TV with a feed of what's happening outside in the dressing room. We want both the Samoan and New Zealand national anthem played. That's the sort of thing that they might say no to at the last minute to mess with you. So you, that level of detail has to go in a contract. So a boxing contract is comprehensive. So I want him to have as little on his plate as possible on the home straight. I'll only bother him about matters, very important commercial, legal, financial matters, of which there are none. I went in today and I gave him a hug, and I gave him a hug and I gave him a kiss and said, I love you and wish you well.
From what, you know, what you see in the media and the person that he is two different things, you know. If you got to know him, you'll see why we get along real well.
I've got his back for life, whether I'm his promoter or not, and vice versa. In the face of a lot of criticism, Joseph has been very loyal and stuck by me, and I'm very grateful for that.
No, he's a great guy. Our relationship goes beyond promoter-fighter. You know, and the reason I say that is because he's got a good heart. He's shown it in many ways. Not just to myself, but to my family and my team.
Holy shit, I have a kid.
Music is life. You know, I need music all the time. Whether it be training, whether it be when I'm relaxing, when it's in the change rooms, whatever, I need music. I need to feel that rhythm, man.
Oh, yeah, you did.
So there's some downtime. I'm just going through emails, making sure I'm on top of things, making sure I've already done all my payments for the month and paid off extra invoices that come through. I think if you just focus on boxing and training, your mind won't be sharp. And you got to keep your mind sharp and you got to keep learning, you got to keep it active. Otherwise, like a volcano, goes dormant. The good thing about PwC, which are my accountants, they have a thing called receipt bank. And so whatever receipts I get from various purchases, I'm able to scan it first, send it directly to them. Then they can sort of sort through the receipts and see which ones are claimable and which ones aren't claimable. It's way easier. See? You don't have to keep it anymore. You can get in a lot of trouble if you make the wrong decisions or wrong choices. I've surrounded myself with people that know what they're doing, people that I trust, people that I know when I go into camp and focus on training, they're doing everything they can to make sure or to ensure that nothing's going to go wrong. With all the fighting, with all the saving up, with all the good decisions I've made with money, I'm able to buy a house now. And it's a house that I'm happy with, a house that my partner's happy with. It's a house that I'm sure my kids will be happy with when they grow up and see it. There's so many things I'm excited about. So I can't say the fight's still not here yet, but once the fight's done, back to New Zealand, and so much more to be excited about, even a fishing program. And we're going to do a fishing program. Parker's fishing program. It's a boring name, we'll change it up.
Come in here, they're going to get a little bit of training footage. I want you to stretch for 10 minutes. If you want to talk to them, if you want to have a little laugh, be just be yourself while you're doing it. And just this here. Yeah, just bullshit, okay? Just
instruction, train like bullshit.
No, train like a champion, give them bullshit.
Yeah, I'm feeling good.
Feel good,
feeling great, feeling relaxed,
pretty relaxed.
Feeling confident.
This camp and the media that we've had has been crazy. Controlled, but crazy. It's like the most meat I've ever done in my life. But in saying that, in the fight game, it's important to have this media because if you don't promote the fight, if you don't get it out there, who's gonna know that we're fighting? So as this camp went by and I started getting in good shape, I started saying more, I started, you know, smiling, I started being better with the media. And when it got to, you know, now that we're actually close to the fight, I'm on fire.
Always looked after and bought a lot of toys and gifts. And she has this big teddy bear. And the teddy bear's name is Barry.
When he realized no one knows more about me than me, then he was fine. And he embraced it, and he was away. Now we can't shut him up.
Did you ask him one question? Ask him one question. And he covered the whole camp. He covered our whole lives, our whole relationship. It only takes one question. But that's what you call experience. Right. Once I get to that stage, actually, I never want to get to that stage.
When I first moved to Vegas, you know, I was very scared and worried to talk to Kev because, you know, intense. But now.
We're on the same team here.
Yes.
Don't you start any recording.
Kev is really intense in the ring, but it's that's how he is. You know, he's not only passionate, but he, you know, he wants this as bad as I want it. He can tell me things and then I can visualize.
When you stick that jab, run the hand up, okay? It's part of being a coach that gets good results is you have to be able to communicate and you have to be able to get your point across. You have to be able to have the intensity when it's required. And you also have to be able to let your guard down.
All right, thank you.
No, I can't do that one.
Germs are not getting sick? No, that's number one.
I don't know if it's paranoia or me just being completely anal as a coach. They are the things that I worry about.
Keep healthy, keep warm, keep out of the cold. You know, we did an interview at the airport.
Jump in, mate.
And the interview had to be in the car. It's the first time I've ever done an interview in a car because they don't want me to be cold. But he's looking out for me, you know. He wants me to be at my best. He wants me to be healthy and strong. And so, thanks, Kev. Thanks for looking out even though the wind wasn't even catching me.
What we set out to do at the beginning of this camp, I said to Joe, we will embrace the occasion, we will live the experience, we will enjoy this journey. Look, the thing is this, there's two very good fighters, both world champions, both undefeated, both with a lot of skill, and it's the person who's going to execute his game plan the best on the night will probably win the fight. I saw him a couple of times when he saw me winch with pain, he threw another couple in there. He's very mean like that.
Did you hear that, Joe?
See, Kev?
One question.
35 minutes later. Come in,
Mother. Right. You proved me right.
Come in, Mother.
So we're off to the tailors to get measured up. It's very important that we look sharp. Yep. Adam was going to do it, but he got lazy, so he suggested we go to
the job.
The reason why the clothes, the suits are big is because they measured me when I was on holiday. Yeah. Now that I'm in training camp, you know, I've slimmed down. But I think it's important that we look the part, you know, in training gear. But when you're attending these sort of events and functions, you got to look smart, sharp. Mm. Like, so when you look sharp, You speak sharp, you fight sharp. Everything is sharp. Lightning! Kabam!
Oh, I don't miss you, man. The shoulder is fine. The sleeve is okay. Only his body.
Only the waist,
yeah,
the body.
Yeah, no problem, sir.
I've been training, so I've gone skinny.
I know, sir, I know. When I was younger, I played boxing in Japan.
Really?
Yeah. But not famously.
Do you have any fights?
Yeah. No. I just fight with the new in the street.
Oh, on the street? Oh, yeah.
Can we take a little bit out of the...
The sleeve?
Yeah.
I
think maybe.
We wear suits every Sunday for church, so I was pretty used to it.
You go to church?
Of course,
that's
brother.
Very good man, very good man.
You have to balance life.
Of course, sir. Now it's okay?
Oh, here we go. Oh, man, you... Magic, you're working your magic.
Thank you, sir. Thanks. You're a good man also.
What time were we actually starting? 12?
Because he's here, we could start on the dot.
So he's actually here?
He's here, and he's very angry.
Why is he angry?
The car guy said he's angry about us challenging him to be on time.
This is the biggest of the biggest. This doesn't get any bigger than this, and sometimes we have to pinch ourselves to see where we are with British boxing.
I reckon Eddie's strategy is to shield AJ from having to talk too much. So I'm going to try and nullify that and challenge him. But here's what I'm thinking. I'm going to say, Eddie, I'm not taking your bait. You're the second best promoter in the world.
But him and I, our job is done. It's not about you, Eddie, and it's not about me. So I'm going to say very little today.
Let Anthony Joshua speak for himself, and I'll do the same with Joseph Parker. Then I'm going to pull my seat back.
And if Eddie comes at me trying to bait me, I'll get off the stage and I'll challenge him to do the same.
And then he'll shout me down and he'll start, and I'll go, stop talking, Eddie. We can smell the silver spoon on your breath. I hope it's under pressure. I hope it works. Those are my thoughts.
That's how you play out in your head?
Yeah.
You play it out if it
and Joseph. Oh, it'll be embarrassing and I'll get mocked again.
I don't know, but if your leg doesn't stop shaking, I'm going to have to move.
Stop talking, Eddie. We can smell the silver spoon on your breath.
There's only one thing I can smell on your breath, and that's last night's activities.
I'm at my best.
Okay.
It was shit delivery. I told him not long ago, I said, bro, you were good, but then you just delivered that so shit.
Let's say I got 20 quid in my pocket and I'm looking at Joseph Parker and Joshua. I believe Anthony Joshua, myself, will knock Joseph Parker out for sure.
I feel ready, I feel confident, I feel sharp. My movement is better than ever. Now I'm taking those belts back to New Zealand and Samoa.
News conference, Joshua posted the image of the head-to-head with Parker with, ooh, scary.
Oh, so
that
childish.
Was it. That's
okay. Toothless looking guy on Twitter private messages me a message that says,
well, that doesn't make sense because they're French.
Where is it? You are a clown. All your chats at the press con today. You are a fool. There is a village missing an idiot somewhere. Oh, it's gold.
I'm sure it looked like he startled Anthony Joshua today, so I guess it's 3-0 to Joe again, so he's got the final presser and then the fight night on Saturday.
Oh, what's up?
The bus trip is always fun, but now that the boys are here, it's even better. Way better. But I can do it when I want, whenever they want. I don't mind. I love myself. You say you gotta get up. Life is more than suicide. I love myself. One day at a time.
one reason why we're here, and this is a once-in-a-lifetime or an opportunity that doesn't happen very often. You're all part of Joe's team. Make sure you give him all the love and support that he needs these next few days, because these next few days are the most important days of his life. And that means he gets the rest and relaxation that he needs and I require him to have. So everybody, get him behind him. Don't put yourself first, put him first. Okay? I don't want to be having this discussion too often. And if you're going out, let's all wear a jacket. If anyone gets sick and starts coughing and sneezing, stay away from Joe. If you see somebody who is sneezing, don't let them anywhere near Joe. I need you all to help me and assist me.
Amen.
Yeah, thank you.
Amen.
It's good, team. Awesome.
Good champ. Thank you, coach.
Thank you, everybody. Nicely covered up. Warm. All right.
The boys have been with me since day one. You know, I said to them, if I ever change, they slap me and bring me back down. And they treat me the same. They laugh if I tell a good joke. They don't laugh if the joke's not that funny. You know, they mock me. So I have no ego.
Give me the receipt.
Huh?
Do you really want to go?
Give me the receipt.
Yeah, bro. Receipt bank.
I'm not sure this is tax deductible, Joe.
Believe it. I want to send it for tourists.
Is this associated with your revenue and
yes.
Activity?
Of course. I need to eat, to train the body. It needs good food.
Who's that?
That is my good friend, Scott McLeaver, also a partner at PwC. He's the one that really that helps me with my finances, make sure I'm on top of things.
The boys are every fight, you know, and they show their love and support by travelling far away to come support me. But to have them around, they keep me relaxed, they keep me calm. It's the, when the boys are around, everything's positive, everything's fun. And we always look to have a great time.
We'll support you on Saturday.
Oh, thank you. Okay. It'll be a good fight.
I will tell all our friends.
How was lunch?
Oh, lovely.
Yeah. Thank you.
You know, I used to be very shy. I used to be very quiet, not good with the media, not too good with people. And if I meet people, I'll just say, hey, how's it going? And then, but now, you know, when I meet people, I love to talk, I love to get to know people.
I should have used you for sparring.
Yeah, no, you're not clean up, just
thank you, bro. Appreciate
if you stayed in South Auckland your whole life and you didn't really meet a lot of people or sort of interact with others, you know, different people from different places, then you'll be the same person that lived in South Auckland all these years ago. But interacting with others, getting to know other people, learning off others, you tend to grow as a person, yeah, and you be more rounded. Right?
Line this way, folks. Just follow me that way. Have to move you. I'm sorry. Good, how are you? I'm good.
Let's go back to there. Joseph, nice to meet you. I'm Neil, one of the doctors.
Thank you.
You sign there for me and I'll examine you. Good. Ribs okay?
Ribs good.
It's best question now. Do you feel fit to box?
Oh, yeah.
Skull champ! Champ is here! Woo! Let's get a champ!
Waiting time.
Dead in the eye, and I don't move until he moves. I can see you, mate. I'm ready. And then, you know, he turns around, sort of turns around and puts his back set the crowd, and then he shakes my hand. All right, man, all the best. I said, yeah, let's go to war. Let's put on a great show. And that was it. There's a cocktail party happening downstairs. I think Eddie Hearn's here, David Higgins is here, Bob Arum is here.
But I'm going with Bob. You've never taken a punch in your life, you don't
know what he's look.
They've asked me if I wanted to come or not, but I decided to, you know, firstly speak to my psychologist, study my notes, And it's these little things that you do behind closed doors when you focus on what you want to do that really helps with the bigger picture. So the small detail really helps. The more you know about yourself, the more you know about your body, the more you know about things leading up to a fight, you can handle any situation that comes your way.
He's edgy because he fears how good Joseph Parker is. He knows this is I think this is the toughest fight of his career.
I've seen myself grow physically, mentally, and like I said, for the fight, I'm looking forward to the challenge. I care about the result, but that's not what's heavy on my mind. What's heavy on my mind is the challenge, and that's the challenge of fighting your opponent who's undefeated, but also the challenge of when you go into the fight and you go into a dark place, how fast can you come out of that dark place? That's the challenge.
You know which one's you gonna win? They said to me, you can't wear white because Joshua is just stuff that guy.
I'll wear what I want.
But I'm taking black just in case.
Fight day could be nerve-wracking if you weren't prepared. Music's playing, the boys are there, we're keeping relaxed. You know, everyone's in a good mood. You think that when it's fight day, you sort of stay away from everyone, but we like to interact with people.
Ready?
Yep.
Come on, Joe.
Oh,
just going on. Yeah, baby! Champ is here!
Yeah,
I see you.
He's superhuman. I couldn't imagine going into that ring tonight how I would feel now. My guts would be churning. The chorus of Josh is going to reverberate on stage. And he's relaxed, and it's like his destiny.
26 years for one night. This is a dream of Joe's. Three belts, doesn't get any bigger than this.
You know the rule. I want a clean fight, okay? No headbutt. I don't see rabbit punch.
Yeah.
I don't see it. No kidney punch, no low blow. Okay, listen to my command. Stop and back. Back. Can I have a picture with you?
Yeah. Yeah, sure.
Camera, headbutt, come in, mirror.
What do you want
to
do?
Okay, now, excuse me.
Thank you very
much.
I'm
a chief second. Is your English good?
English?
Yeah.
A little.
Okay. Now, you said before, stop. Are you going to be saying break or stop?
Break, step back.
Step back.
Okay.
Okay. And stop, step back, and the box.
Okay. Now, when they work in close, what are you going to do? Are you going to let them work in close? If they hold, are you going to break it up? What are we going to do?
If we close, or break, or punch.
Clinch.
Yeah.
Break and step back.
Okay.
Sorry, I don't understand.
That's going to make it very difficult for me to ask these questions then, isn't it?
he's a world-class referee. He knows what he's doing.
He's asking, are you going to allow them to fight on the inside?
I need to know this.
Yes.
Okay, so you just can't come in and walk out. I need to know.
Always stop quickly. Stop quickly or let them fight?
No. Go to fight.
No, allow you to fight.
Yeah,
yeah,
yeah. Fight.
Yeah.
Okay. All right. Good luck, referee.
Good luck.
Thank you.
Okay, good luck.
Yeah, good luck.
So what happens in these big fights is a representative from our crew go and watch them rap. Taylor's done that. So he'll go in and make sure they're doing nothing that they shouldn't be doing. And the representative of their team will do the same to us. Kevin spends like 45 minutes on each hand. Everybody we've come across has said, that's a great rap. I've never seen a rap like it.
Getting the hands wrapped, I noticed that the guy from Joshua's team has a problem with the wrap, or has a problem with some sort of tape that we have.
What's it actually made of? I personally think he's not going to let you use
that. I don't really worry about what's happening. I, like I said, I trust in my team, but me, I just stay on task, stay focused, just relax.
And you're with British Boxing Board?
British Boxing Board, yes.
This is the first time in
at Mr. Parker's career 24 fights, yeah, where we've had this sort of...
How many in Britain? How many in Britain?
Oh, Rob.
Well, it just happens that the last fight was in Britain.
Just because you got away with it the last
one. What do you mean, got away with it?
Well, just allowed to
we've fought 24 fights the same way, and it's been acceptable around the world.
Yeah.
And against Anthony Joshua was the first time. Yeah. It's not us trying to get away with anything.
But you know the tape we use.
It's to go on after the tape.
So your hand doesn't move around in the glove.
I can see no advantage to anybody, no disadvantage. So as long as he goes on top and not through doing that, I'm happy with that, okay? However, on the glove, it has to be this.
Yes.
Okay? Right, thank you.
Thank you very much.
Appreciate it.
Thank you. Appreciate it.
Clutch, Dave. Clutch, Dave. There he is.
Oh, there's lots of little things that need to, little moments like that where it could go one way or the other. It's all psychological. It could be that Joshua want to change our routines on the home straight. There's a lot of psychological warfare as well as the battle in the ring.
As Rob just said, can we put Vass on the reps?
Tay walks in and I notice that he's talking about Joshua putting Vass on his reps and doing some, I know, just not doing the normal things with his reps.
So we're putting Vaseline on the outside of the hand?
Yeah, so he puts it in the
Jesus, it's like one thing after the other, isn't it?
It's been done before, it's not been objective to.
Vitaly
Klitschko did it.
Yeah. Vitaly's been retired for a long time.
Yeah, Josh retired him.
No, that's Vladimir.
That's Vladimir, mate.
It's the younger brother.
What? Yeah, that's it. Yeah. Come on,
that's not his first fight. Okay, so what are we doing with these ones? There's his first choice of fights. Yeah, he was over
there fucking doing this for about
a minute on live TV. Really? This changes the fight. You know, him squeezing and pushing on the padding of the glove so there's no padding. It's fucking cheating.
Okay, are you going to allow him to keep doing that to the gloves?
No, of course not, no.
Well, did you say anything when you were doing it before?
I didn't see it at the time.
He did, but
he's very quick to...
But, you're supposed to be our eyes because he's not in there the whole time.
We were quick
He's only in there watching the rapping.
Okay, we were quick to react.
Okay, but come on, it's like he holds two world title belts. He knows better than that.
Here we go, baby.
GN helping to beat Anthony Joshua in the name of Jesus Christ, amen.
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 Let's do it, baby.
At this point, I'm just thinking about who I'm doing this for. My family, who I love and care for. John, because he's not able to fight. I started thinking to myself, it's time.
Let's get ready to rumble!
I want a clean fight, okay? Good luck.
The first few rounds were good. The movement was the best it's ever been. The jab was popping out. I felt it was going good. I felt it was going really good in the beginning. I went to throw a jab and he threw a jab at the same time. I noticed that the reach was an issue because in order for me to land my punches, I had to get in close.
There we go. Parker starts to unload here. Joshua went for it.
I landed some good shots, and I landed some shots to the body, came up to the head, but it was always broken up.
It looks to me that Parker's growing in confidence here, Carl. Every time they get close, he's splitting them up.
I was thinking, keep doing what you're doing, but just don't get disqualified or don't get a point taken off you. Listen to the ref, but do your best to get in when you can.
This is better for Parker. That's good round this from Joseph Parker.
He lands a good left hook. I get in close and I try to fire back. The ref stops it. I just look at him and smile and wink. Is that all you have?
And this is where Joshua looks powerful and strong. been a real gallant effort, this, from Joseph Parker.
In hindsight, I think what I could have done differently in the later rounds was put on more pressure, throw more punches, because I felt that when I did put on pressure and chase him down, I was getting the better of him.
Winner by unanimous decision, Anthony Joshua!
And it was hard seeing Joe fight every round and seeing the big blows and big punches being exchanged. It was, you know, heart-wrenching. Every punch just, it felt like I was getting hit.
It's never good to lose. You know, it's something I find really hard. But, you know, we were beaten by a good big man tonight.
And I think we saw dignified, gracious Joseph Parker walk back with more hunger and fire in his belly.
The best is yet to come. Joe's 26. He's a baby in the sport. You know, Joe will be champion again. I promise.
So proud of him. God, I'm immensely proud of him. And I just hope that, you know, all New Zealand and Samoa are proud of him. You know, it was a courageous effort. You know, this is going to be massive for the profile of Joseph Parker. You know, Paco, the president of the WBO, and Gilbert Mendoza from the WBA both came up in the ring afterwards and said, we'll give you all the support moving forward we possibly can. You know, we love you guys and we love Joe.
Couldn't be more proud.
Get that gloomy look off your face and we're going to go party.
Let's go. Yeah.
Now that I sort of think about the training camp that we've had, I'm a totally different person from, you know, what I was before, you know. Now I know about clean eating. Now I know about focus. Now I know about working hard, resting well. And all these things that I've learned as a fighter or as a person, I'm going to take it with me for future fights or for whatever I do in life. Because now it's not only part of boxing, but it's a part of life. John, like myself, we enjoy life together. You know, we do everything together. John's been to the doctor. They've scheduled him in to get it sorted at some stage in the near future. And once that's sorted, John's going to be dangerous again. He's going to be back. This is just the beginning. I'm still young. I'm hungry to be champion again. I think, you know, maybe I lost one belt now, but in future I can get four back. It's a quiet heart like a car alarm. Hollow chest, it's a hollow chest. You know, when I was in the fight, when I was walking out, in the beginning when we were walking out, you know, throwing beer at us. We were walking out and when I was standing there and we couldn't really hear the walkout song because it was real loud. And you get beer thrown at us. And sort of turn around and it was Heineken.